the direction of the market. Yeah, okay. This is US 30. US 30, we see that it's going, is an uptrend, right? What do you think, Sophia? What do you think? What trend is this one? This is not, this is US 30. So this is US 30, this is US 30. You see that the market has been going up. It's an uptrend. Now let us spot, if we can spot for our key levels, we are going to see that the daily time frame is just to show us the main trend, like the overall direction of the market. And we can see that this is a bullish market. This is a bullish market, and the market has been going up, 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 up. So the nature of this market is, let's see, what's the nature of this market? We see an impulse. Impulse correction, impulse correction, correction, impulse, like correction, it is double top, then it came down. So all this is like a correction phase, then an impulse again. So market was just going like this, going up, up, but in this corrective form. So let's see now. We check, this market is a bullish market. Let's look for our key levels. Our key levels. If we see, let's first spot for our key levels. We have here, this was a key level. It was a key level that was broken. This one was a key level that was also broken. This was a key level that, this was a key level, a support. If you guys can see, it went, it came to retest, it broke, it came to retest. It went to retest again, then it broke, it came to retest, then it came to retest again, it came to retest. So these are the key levels, meaning that if market come again here in the future, it might do the same thing. It might react again the same way it did in the past. So let's leave from there. Let's go here close to the price, where the price is. Let's not go too far. Let's check again, where are the key levels again that we can spot here? Is this was a resistance. Okay, you can say that this is our key level. Yeah, if you see, let me zoom in. You zoom in, this market here, it was an impulse, then it was like correcting, but it was going up. So then it fell again down, then it went again up. So our key levels, it was here, market came, it tested, it came down, it tested again, then it broke, it came to retest, it came and broke, retested, and came down. After coming down, it broke, then it came to retest again here. So what next? Then we come again, we look, because we just all we want to find where is the current or the nearest support or resistance that we want. We are looking from here. We see that, okay, this was a resistance, but now it became the support. Then it broke down, came to retest, it came down, it broke. Then, after that, we can leave this one. What we can do, we can just break this one. This was a resistance. This is a key level. This is a key level that was broken. So meaning that all these down, we are no longer paying attention here, down. All where we are mostly paying attention, this one here. This is the key level, the recent one that was broken. So let's move to our lower time frame. Let's go to the 4-hour time frame. Our 4-hour time frame. Okay, if you see that this was a resistance, then it was broken. So we're expecting for the market to come and retest. But since this market broke this resistance impulsively, that's why it did not come, or it did not came to retest. But it can come in the near future to come and retest before it goes up. So we see that, okay, market already violated this resistance, so but it has created again some sort of structure here, like some sort of level on the 4-hour time frame, which is this one. Market came to retest again, it created a double bottom. Yeah, it went, so it broke this resistance here. So that is our resistance. This is our resistance that was broken again. Can you see market? It always does the same thing, breaks and retests, break and what. Then we go to our 1-hour time frame. Can you see the market always does the same thing? Here the market broke because it was impulsively, it was the impulse phase. Here it was just correcting. Impulse, correction, impulse. Now here market was doing the same thing, was correcting, then it broke impulsively. So now what we're expecting is for this market just either to come and retest. We're expecting for it to come and then proceed up. Can you see how fast it is? All this is what the market has been doing. The market was always impulse correcting, then impulse correcting, impulse correcting. Now we are again on the impulse. Even if you measure, if it's to measure this, let me take this. So that we can measure something, then you'll see from here until here where it came to stop. Take this just to measure it until here. All right. Then from here until here. So now we are also expecting the same type of movement, maybe from here until here, somewhere here, before maybe it comes again, just to go like this. So market will always repeat the same thing. All we need is just to plan for our trade. We don't just trade in disorder, no, we have to trade according to our plan so that we can have enough confidence to take a trade. Yeah, so this is for US Fed. We are expecting the market just to continue going up. Since it broke impulsively, it might not come and retest here. It you might just create also a level somewhere there and proceed going up. But this is what I'm expecting. Go like this, because the market has been creating higher low, higher low, higher low. This was the previous higher high, it broke. So it has to create again another higher low before it proceeds up. Maybe it will go up, then it will create that higher low and proceed up. So did you get it? Okay, yeah, so very, very, very easy. You just need to find what is the trend, identify the trend of the market. Then from there, after identifying the trend of the market on that high time frame, start looking for your key levels. If those key levels are still very valid, then you can use them. If they are not valid anymore, then you can leave them. Do something else. Yeah, as long as they are valid, then you need to utilize those key levels. Can you see what happened? Can you see what happened? This is what it happened with US 30. This is what happened. This is what happened here. So it was a resistance. It broke. Then it came. I think it already retested. Yeah, it already retested. Yeah, it came here. Came down, then it broke, retested, then it went up. So this market, it won't come again until it will create a sort of support. I don't know where. Maybe until here, or until here, or until here, and then continue going up. Just to create another higher low before it continues. Yeah, so I think we are done for today. Thank you so much for those that came through. So yeah, so for the rest that did not come, they have to go and watch this video on YouTube. Yeah, so for those that attended, thank you so much.
It's a Pinto. Mm-hmm. We only analyzed the support and the resistance, but then we didn't go to stop loss and all that.
Stop loss.
Yeah.
Okay. Look, let's say that. Let's say you want to buy from here, right? Let's say when you saw the market, this was the expectation, the market to go and break, ne? And then proceed up, right? That was your expectation. Ne?
Yes.
Okay. If your expectation is like, if market breaks here, if market breaks this zone, I'm waiting for a retest and then to proceed before it proceeds up. What to do? Just check. Okay, this is my resistance. This is my resistance, my key level. Né? This is my resistance, the key level. This is my key level. This is my key level. Né? So I have to put my stop, I will make sure that my stop loss should be under this resistance of mine. You have to make sure that your stop loss must be under. If I'm going to enter from here, meaning that my stop loss, I should put it under here, because I know that, okay, the market already broke my resistance, and then it came to retest. Can you see this candle? This is a bullish engulfing. This one. This after this red one, there is this green one.
Mm-hmm.
After spotting that engulfing, bullish engulfing, you can even put your, you can enter from here, then you put your stop loss here down, because you know that this market won't reach here. This price won't reach again here. Even if you can see, check this weak rejection. Check this weak rejection. Check, this is where the market, this is where the market is reaching and is rejecting. Can you see recently? This is recently. This is where the candles are reaching, but they're not breaking here. So you can even do what? You can even bring your stop loss until somewhere, because you know that okay, the price is not reaching this zone. It's not reaching this. It's not closing below this weak rejection. So then I put my stop loss here. Then my take profit. I can put it anywhere I want. Like on top. If I know that no, this market it will go up for so long, then I won't put my take profit. I'll just put a stop loss, so that if the market come against me, it will take me out and it won't blow my account.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, can you see? This is the resistance that you say, okay, if market breaks, it has to retest. After retesting, it has to go up. When you see that bullish engulfing or a hammer or a morning star or a bullish engulfing, then you enter. Then you just put your stop loss far from those recent weak rejection that you saw there. Can you see? Very easy. Once, that's why I say you trade, you plan your trade. Trade your plan. Don't just trade because the market is going up. No, you have to analyze. After analyzing it, then you spot, okay, when the market come until here, I'm going to buy. If the market does like this, I'm going to sell. And I'm going to put my stop loss, because this thing is very clear. You know that the market is rejected. Check here. The first rejection, second rejection, third rejection, fourth rejection. Then the green candle started appearing. That was giving you a sign. That was giving you a sign. When you saw this doji, when you saw this doji, this cross here, it was already a sign. It was a bullish sign that was already appearing, showing to you. If you can see, here, first one, second one, third, the fourth one, it started becoming green. The fifth one, it was now confirming you. Then this one, this is a hammer. It confirmed you nicely. After you see that one, you can enter from there. Then you put your stop loss below here, because you know that okay, this market is not closing. This price is not reaching this time. Then you buy. Then you just buy. Then you wait until the market starts giving you your money. Are we clear?
Yes.
Yeah, it's very easy, my sister. As long as you see the market is reacting, there is rejecting, a lot of rejection. You check for your candlestick. Check for your candlestick, the reversal one, the buying candlestick. When you spot them, then you don't fear. Then you jump in, put your stop loss just under.
Yeah.
Can you see it? It was rejecting. When you saw those rejections, they are telling you, because it's already part of your plan. You already say, okay, if the market breaks here, I will wait for a retest and then I'll proceed. That's what it happened here. The market broke, then came to retest here. It broke. Then it came to retest, simple.
Yeah.
Then the market came to the test, then it started shooting up. Simple, when you just spot that, you already know that, oh, this is what I was looking for. So you won't even fear because it's part of your plan. It's something that you plan already at the market. It has to do like this, then it will come down, then it will go. Then I'll put my stop loss under here, and I'm gone. Are we together, ne?
We are.
All right, my sister. Thank you. I see others, they did not came through on this second meeting. The first one, they were all here, most of them. Yeah, but this one. Yeah, but as I told you that the more you practice me, I won't make you to become a better trader. Like, as long if you don't practice, there's no way you're going to become someone that you want to be. So
it's true.
For me, all I do is just to share my knowledge, what I know with you, so that you can all become one, like rich, become in the same level. Yeah, so but the rest, you have to put more effort on yourself.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
But I have a suggestion, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, it's a suggestion, a proposal. Maybe it will be good if you share the link early.
Yeah, it's true, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So we can just divide our work schedules to see mm-hmm. and to know that this time is meant for...
Yeah,
and then maybe we can take it off from there.
Yeah.
But otherwise, your knowledge is helpful.
Thank you.
It's just a matter of practice.
Yeah.
But so far, whatever it is that you have been sharing with us is legit.
Yeah.
Although trading itself does not just come in one night or one day and then off already you have it.
Yeah.
Now and then you will have to go to repeat again just for you to have it.
Yeah.
And so, but otherwise, whatever it is that you have been sharing with us,
yeah,
it's similar to what other traders are also sharing on their YouTubes and so forth.
All right. All right, my sister. Thank you. Have a beautiful week. And more profit to your side. Hope you are, this week you are going to maybe to focus or to be on the blue side.
Yeah,
just remember
I'm
that
I'm still practicing.
Yeah, practice, don't give up, practice. I'm telling you, then you'll believe the power of practicing. You'll then believe the power of practicing.
Yes.
Yeah, so thank you so much. Have a good night. See you next week.
Likewise.
Yeah, see you next week.
Thank you for your time. Greetings to the family.
All right, thank you. Likewise.
Bye.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Meredith. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Bye.
Bye. Yeah, guys, we are done for meeting. Some they were not around. Yeah, but yeah. Mm-hmm.